I'm going to describe multiple effect evaporation. The idea is we take a feed that's in green here, feed that is a 5 weight percent sugar solution, and we concentrate the sugar so that as we go through the stages, we end up with, in this case, 13.2% sugar solution by evaporating some of the water from the solution. Now we do the evaporation by having a heat exchanger that we feed saturated steam. So the red saturated steam, which then leaves here as saturated water. And the advantage of these multiple effects is that when we evaporate some of the water from the sugar solution, and that ends up being this blue stream, that steam is used in the next effect of the evaporation. So we move from left to right with the sugar solution, the green, so we now feed a liquid into the second effect. We feed the liquid in that's higher concentration of sugar. It goes in then to the third effect, again at higher concentration, till we end up with, in this case, 13.2%. But the significant advantage is, instead of using additional outside steam, we use the evaporated water in the second stage. In order for that to work and have a temperature difference, we run the second effect, the second stage, at a lower pressure, and therefore a lower boiling temperature. And then the third stage, we do the same thing. So the steam from the second stage goes into the third stage, again at a lower pressure and a lower temperature. So again, we have a temperature difference for heat transfer. And the idea here, we calculate a steam economy, and that corresponds to the fact that instead of having to feed fresh saturated steam in each stage, by using the steam we create in the first stage, we can get more net water evaporated from our sugar solution than steam that we feed in. So for the conditions picked here, we feed 1 kilogram of steam here, and we evaporate a total of 1.27 kilograms of water from our water solution. The simulation allows us to vary the feed pressure and the feed flow rate. The other aspect of the simulation is that I'm showing here the triple effect, but we also can look at a double effect and a single effect evaporator to see the differences in efficiency. Now, I should point out this is a forward feed system in that we're feeding the steam going in the same direction the evaporated water and the more concentrated sugar solution. It's also possible to do a reverse effect. So let's look at the simulation to understand a little better the behavior. So here's the simulation. You notice it says you can hover the cursor over each stream and you get more information. So if we look at this saturated steam leaving the first effect, it gives us a flow rate and its temperature. And then likewise leaving the second effect, the saturated water from the heat exchanger gives the flow rate. Of course, the same flow rate is coming in as steam. And we've concentrated the liquid in the first stage to 8.8% and then in the second stage to 11.3%. If I increase the feed pressure, notice I increase the steam economy. And I'm also, of course, increasing the temperatures in the various effects. If I increase the flow rate so that we get more going through, so let's go back and look at that. Notice increasing the flow rate, I'm lowering the sugar concentration in my concentrate because I'm processing much more. I'm increasing the steam economy, so it's above 2. So this demonstrates the significant increase in energy efficiency by using a multiple effect evaporator. This simulation also has a double effect evaporator And in this case, we can label the various streams by clicking on Show All Streams. And then the single effect evaporator, and you'll notice that we actually have efficiency slightly greater than 1, and this is just related to the fact that heat of vaporization is a function of temperature or saturation pressure, and so the feed stream at 154 degrees has a different heat of vaporization than the saturated steam that we feed in at 200 degrees C. So we use mass and energy balances to calculate the differences for these multiple effect evaporators, and it shows that we can get more efficiency, utilize our energy better by having additional effects.